Right to Heaven Part 1 Welcome, welcome, welcome. My beautiful beings of light. Shine on my brilliant beings of grace, for darkness has no place in your world. Be the candles and the mighty lighthouses that you are. Beam your light so that others can find their way amongst the shadows and dark crevices. Light and love are seeping into all the places that have been filled with hopelessness and despair for eons. You are making a difference. Job well done. Keep holding the light and sending out love and divine grace. Love and the Creator's divine grace are two of the energies that can be sent to anyone without interfering with their divine will. Divine grace and love also cannot be re-qualified into any other energies but what they truly are. When you are praying for another, my beloveds, remember to ask the Creator for whatever is for the benevolent outcome and divine highest good of the person, animal, place, thing, etc. It isn't necessary to advise the Creator of your desired outcome or expectation or share your laundry list. Remember, the Creator knows all intimately and knows just what is appropriate for that situation, person, animal, place, etc. at all times. The Creator, my beloveds, also knows how all that fits into the Divine Master Blueprint and what the contracts were that are playing out with the desired lessons, etc. that are to be achieved and completed. There is so much more in the bigger pictures, my beloveds, that you do not see or remember or understand at this juncture. This is where faith comes in and is critically important. My beautiful beings of grace, pray with feelings and emotion and sincere intent for whatever is for the benevolent outcome and divine highest good for that situation and all concerned. This sounds so simple, but this is the biggest, most powerful prayer, my divine beings of grace, that you will ever need when praying. Allow the Creator and the celestial realm to hear your intent echoed from your heart and feel the sincere emotions for your desires and requests for another or whatever the circumstance might be. Then surrender all to the realm that can help. Feel the feelings of placing the person or situation into the Creator's etheric hands, and with those deep-seated feelings and emotions, imagine handing this over to the Creator for the benevolent outcome and divine highest good of all concerned. Know when you have done this, that actions will be taken in whatever way that is appropriate. Leave the request with your Creator and angels to resolve in whatever way is divinely guided in divine timing. My beloveds, when praying for yourselves, keep the same directions in mind. Your Creator and angels know more about your needs, agreements, desires, contracts than you can ever imagine or remember at this moment in now. It is remembering to ask that is hard for humans to do. Your human selves believe that they can solve all things, that is the ego, my beloveds, telling you stories. A prayer can be as simple as help me, and it is heard instantly, my beautiful beings of grace. Praying with deep sincere emotions and feelings, as if you have already received the outcome, is another really important component to prayer. Try praying perhaps something like this: my dear God, help me, at this moment I am feeling so overwhelmed and hurt. The path that I am to take is unclear. I know you are aware of all going on in my life, along with knowing all of my needs and requirements. I am asking for whatever is for my benevolent outcome and my divine highest good for myself and all others concerned. My Creator, I am humbly turning this all over to you, and know that I will be guided in whatever way that is appropriate for the situation. It is in your hands. Thank you for your guidance. Amen. And so it is, and so it is. My beloved's prayers of gratitude and thanks are appreciated at all times as well. Prayer doesn't just need to be about something you think is an issue for yourself or others or situations, etc. Thank the Creator for all the wonder and beauty in your life, regardless of how major or minor that may be. The simple thanks for awaking to a new day is one way to begin, my beloveds. Find something to be thankful for each day and relay that thanks to your Creator. It is in finding things to be thankful for that more will be provided to enjoy. Writing to Heaven, my beautiful beings of light, is another way of communicating. Sometimes it is easier for a person to express themselves using written words. Know that the same guidelines apply. Writing to Heaven, my beloveds, isn't journaling, where one allows all the toxic debris to be recorded and flood out onto a page. Writing to Heaven is a written prayer requesting assistance for benevolent outcomes and divine highest good for you and all those concerned. Also, write to Heaven and express your gratitude, thanks, and appreciation. Send up the message that you are open to remembering, finding, and rediscovering your joy. Send up the message that you also observe and appreciate others receiving joy. Joy is, my beloveds, your natural state, when you are not having a human experience. A question that you might want to ask yourself is, how far away am I from my joy? The answer to that question can trigger a perception within you, to how much dense debris is dragging you down. If nothing more, it provides an awareness to clearing work that needs to begin. Allow this messenger to take you on a mediation journey to experience and remember your connection. Sit in a chair or lie down, whichever is your preference. It's time to be comfortable and undisturbed for a while as you journey within yourself through meditation. Close your eyes and take a few deep breaths in and out. Visualize with each in-breath, you are breathing in love and renewal. With each out-breath, you are breathing out pain, fear, frustrations, and doubts. With the last out-breath, feel your body relaxing. Allow and give yourself permission to feel the calm, peace, and serenity of this safe place. My beloveds, ask your ego self to perch on your left shoulder. Instruct your ego self that it is only to be an observer on this journey, it is not to participate. Through prayer to the Creator, please ask the Creator to share with you a translucent golden shield of light. Visualize it all around you, forming a bubble from head to toe, protecting you from all outside influences and giving you warmth, radiance, light, and power. Negatives will simply bounce harmlessly off your golden shield of protective light. My beloveds, the Creator has responded to your prayer. Your protective bubble has been supplied. The energies for this bubble will continue to flow from the Creator, cycling back down through you again, and back to the Creator in a continuous circular loop while you are in meditation. You are now divinely protected at this moment, and nothing can even communicate with you that is not for your highest good, without your permission. Breathe in deeply, my beautiful beings of light, and sense the lighter, relaxed feelings of being divinely protected and guided into this meditation. Breathe in deeply and know that you are breathing to the pulse of the Creator. Breathe in deeply, allowing, seeing, and sensing within your spiritual imagination your guardian angels and invited spirit guides as they join you now. The angels take your spiritual etheric essence hands and guide you out of your physical body. The angels then direct you into your etheric spiritual heart chakra. An angel is staying with your physical essence until you return from your meditation journey. My beloveds, you are visualizing, seeing, feeling, and sensing this within your imagination. Your guardian angels, spirit guides, and special invited guests are with you now within your spiritual heart chakra. Your angels and guides are helping you locate the golden door that says to my highest guidance within. In your imagination, you have located the golden door, and now you turn the etheric spiritual doorknob, opening the door as you cross over the threshold, knowing that you are on a spiritual growth adventure. You find yourself in a white marble corridor. Your angels whisk you down the hall to the 111th door to your right. The door label is Connection. You open the door and cross over the threshold, and there waiting for you on the driveway is a white Rolls-Royce limousine. You go, wow. That is a beautiful car, and your angels nod their heads and tell you that this car is yours and has always been yours. You notice that it also has a chauffeur in the driver's seat. Yes, your angels respond as they read your thoughts about your wonder and awe over this beautiful car and driver. The chauffeur is with you always, your angels explain. The car is glowing, and you can feel the love energy just circulating around the car and towards you. When you look really closely, you can see a pink mist created by the love waves reverberating out towards you. Noticing even further now, listening closely, you hear a faint song being played on the car's radio. Your angels explain that this is your song that the Creator gifted you with when you were initially birthed into creation.